please keep it down. And I'd like to ask Ginger Howard to come up and address the crowd, please. Once again, please keep the noise down.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having me. Good morning. How are you? I am from South Georgia. I'm from a little town called Waycross, Georgia, but I moved to the big city after I graduated from University of Georgia, and I moved to Washington, D.C. on a dare right out of college because I was such not a risk taker back then. Right now, I'll take any risk you can imagine, but back then, when I was a little girl, I wouldn't even spend the night out because I was homesick. So some friends dared me one day that I would never move, and I said, oh, I'll move, and they said, where are you going to move? I said, oh, let me pick. I'll move to Washington, D.C. I literally moved to Washington, D.C. on a dare. I did not have a job. I did not have a place to live. And my car broke down on the way up there. So I thought, uh-oh. But it all turned out great. And I moved when George H.W. Bush got elected the first time. Well, the only time. But that was such an exciting time. And I really got a bug for politics. And that was when Lee Atwater was chair of the RNC. And you all, if you've been around for a while, you remember what an amazing chairman he was. And I wanted to work so badly on the Hill, but I went to Georgia and I majored in fashion merchandising. That is my background. I have a small business. I have a clothing store in Atlanta. But I didn't want to work in fashion. I wanted to work on the Hill. I had no experience. All I had ever done was selling clothes. But I knocked on every door on the Hill. I want to work for you. Nobody would hire me. But I had a friend who worked at the RNC, and they graciously said, well, you can work on the phone banks. So I started working part-time on the phone banks. My main job was a manager of a beautiful clothing store in Alexandria, but they gave everybody a script to use, except I didn't use the script. And all of a sudden, the money started going up and up and up, and they'd come over and listen to me. I was not using my script. And people were saying, honey, I'll give you whatever amount of money you want if you'll just keep talking with that accent. So they'd let me call the North and the Midwest, and I raised a lot of money for the RNC. That was my first bug in politics. And those of you that are here, you know, once you get the political bug, it never leaves you. But the thing is, the thing that drove me to Washington was the thing that drove me away. And I got homesick and I moved back, but I never got out of that love for politics. So I moved to Atlanta, Georgia 20 years ago, and I got involved in the grassroots. I started working on Saxby Chambliss's campaign, and I just really, really got involved, and I loved it. And I have been an entrepreneur for 23 years, and I have a heart for this country. And the Republican National Committee, their main mission is to provide national leadership for the Republican Party. So I have reflected on the kind of leader that I would like to be. And I've come up with three leaders that I have watched in my lifetime. And I want to emulate some of their characteristics. And the first one is Ronald Reagan. And one of the things that I love about Ronald Reagan, there's so many things we love about Ronald Reagan, but one of the greatest things I love about him is that he was called the Great Communicator. And in his farewell speech, he said, you know, I really wasn't the great communicator. I just communicated great things. And I want to communicate great things to you today, that we have a hope, we have a future, we have a wonderful country, and our best days are not behind us, they're ahead of us. And if we all unite and we lock arms, and if you were for Ted Cruz, or you were for John Kasich, or you were for Donald Trump, or you were for Rick Perry like me, you lock arms with your fellow Republican, your fellow conservative, and you say, we want to take this country back. We have hope, we believe, we can do it if we all unite. Let's all say that you're 80% friend is not your 20% enemy. For heaven's sakes, everyone in this room doesn't want Hillary Clinton to be elected, so guess what? We're 100% unanimous on that. So that's my number one leader that I want to emulate. And number two, my second leader that I love is George W. Bush. And one of the things I love is he had a servant's heart. And many of you don't even know the things, I don't even know the things he's done behind the scenes for our military. Remember the time that he flew to Iraq when it was very dangerous for him to go? He left his family on Thanksgiving, and I'm in my kitchen at my mother's house, and I look up, and there's George Bush serving turkey to the soldiers in Iraq, and I just started crying. He left his family. His advisor said, don't go, this is not safe. But he said, they are making a sacrifice for me. How can I not go? And when he was a little boy, his mother taught him the proverb, let another praise you and not your own lips. And that's another thing I want to be. I want to be a servant leader who does not toot my own horn. I want to just do the work that he, like George Bush did. And my number three leader is Rick Perry. I had the privilege of serving short term on his campaign for president this past time. I was his state chair. But he had a slogan that said, show me, don't tell me. And he did that in Texas. He would tell you something, but he would do it. And so many people, and that is why we're so frustrated now. That is why Donald Trump has resonated with so many people. So many politicians run on a platform and they tell you something and it sounds so wonderful and we all jump on their bandwagon, but then they get there and they don't do what they said they're gonna do. I wanna be a woman of my word. There's a psalm that's one of my favorite verses. It says, you keep your oath even when it hurts. And sometimes it hurts. It's hard to make those decisions. And the main thing of a committee woman is to vote and to vote rightly. And I want to vote to keep our platform, God in our country, religious liberty, sanctity of life, marriage between a man and a woman. The fact that we would even have to discuss that now in our nation. Our forefathers pledged their lives, their fortune, and their sacred honor to stand for religious liberty. I want to stand for you. My tagline for my election is Georgia's conservative voice to the RNC. You all have so many voices. I have been all over the state since January the 5th, and I want to tell you, I want to synthesize all that you've been telling me and be that one voice to the RNC. So if you're a delegate or an alternate on June 4th, I would love your vote. GingerHoward.net, Ginger for Georgia. Thank you and God bless you.